Hi, folks. First off, look at my spiffy new haircut. I get one twice a year, and this was it. Today, I thought I'd talk a little bit, especially to you folks who don't have an RV yet, or you folks that are looking to maybe upgrade to something bigger. The next time I go looking for an RV, these are the things that I want to look for. The first thing is getting into it. How high is the first step? My first step on this thing was 2 feet in the air. Now, if you're going to spend a lot of time in a full hookup RV site with the cement pads and all that, it's fine because the cement pads are about a foot thick. So now I'm only looking at maybe a foot to get up into the camper. But if you're going to stay in state parks or your BLM land or you're going to go boondocking, that 2 foot may be a problem. If you have a little bit of difficulty getting into it in the first place, it's not going to get any better. So you may consider a footstool, or you may consider trying to find something a little lower to the ground. The second thing, when I first walk in, I look at the layout, because I don't know about you, but I'm a couch potato. I love to lay on the couch and watch television, which is one reason I chose this, because the couch runs right along here on this side. The TV's right over here, so I can lay on the couch and I can watch television. If you are like me, and you do like to lay on a couch, lay on the couch, because I found some that were glorified love seats and I couldn't straighten out. I couldn't get comfortable. They were too narrow. My arm was hanging off the edge. So you might want to check that too. Another thing is when you first look at these, no matter whether it's a private sale or in a RV dealer or what, the thing is wide open. All the slide outs are open and you can see how spacious and beautiful and gorgeous it is. Well, if you get a chance, pull the slide outs in and see if you've got enough room to get around. I know with this one, I have to take one of my chairs and put it in front of the door before the slide out will come in. So I can't use that door. Luckily, I have another door in the bedroom, so I can get into the bedroom, I can get to the bed, I can get to the bathroom, and I have enough room here to go in and make myself a meal if I was in a Walmart parking lot. So check the area when the slides are in and make sure you can use them if you're overnighting someplace. Another thing, this is just a personal preference, but I'd think long and hard about getting a camper that had a Norcold refrigerator in it. For the last couple years, there's been so many recalls and people posting on forums about my Norcold quit, and I've got all these goofy error messages, and in order to reset it, you got to push this here and push this here and stick your elbow here and lift your leg and bang your head 3 times, and I've got a Dometic and I love it. I have 3 buttons, on and off, auto and gas, and that's it. I don't have error codes, I don't have any of that nonsense. I've been using this thing full time for over 2 years now, and I've never had a lick of trouble. I saw one time where there was a recall on Dometics, and I checked my model number, and my model number wasn't on the list. So I highly recommend Dometics, and I'm real leery about Norcold refrigerators. Another thing I would do is I would stand in the shower, number one, to make sure that your head's not up where the fan is and the little skylight. And another thing is I like to check the height of the shower head. I stood in some of these where the shower head was about right here. So in order to take a shower, you got to lift the thing up or scooch down or lift it up and get your hair wet, and then you've got water in your eyes and you're trying to find it to put it back in. You lather yourself up and now you're reaching for this thing with the soap and trying to I would rather have a shower like mine. This one is about 2 or 3 inches above my head, and it's perfect. I don't have to go through any gyrations in order to take a shower. Another thing is the bedroom. This one, for example, has what they call a walk-around bed. And the reason you can walk around the bed is because it has what's called an RV queen or a short queen. First time I laid on this bed, the edge of the mattress was above my ankles. That's not going to work. I'm almost 6'1". I needed something a little longer. So I ended up throwing it out and getting a full-size queen mattress. Once I did that, it's a lot harder to walk around the bed than it was originally. So that's another thing to consider. And finally, the closets. Most of these have the headboard against the front wall, and then you've got a closet here, you've got cupboards across here, and you got a closet down this way. Most of these, depending on where the bar is, are too short to hang a shirt. You end up grabbing the bottom of the shirt and scrunching it up and pushing it in there so you can get the door closed, and it's just too short for anything. So you only have three choices. You can try to raise the bar, but if you raise it too high, you can't get the coat hanger over it. You can take the floor out so that your clothes hang properly, but then you're looking at clothes swinging in the air conditioning, and that looks like shit. Or you can take the bar out entirely and put in a couple metal shelves and just fold everything. So that's something else to consider. And I guess that's it. But next time I look for an RV, I'm going to look for things like this. Talk to you later.